installed in both in a client side and server side. That means the company is installing the app, the employee's device means, so that he can remotely control the employee's device through this app. Let me be shown in this image.
The core idea of the app is not only monitoring what the employees in the enterprise is doing, but also to it's a kind of a parental guide. We have a multiple usage for this core idea of this app actually. If you want to have a tic-tac kind of message should be shared between two devices, you can able to easily do this. The main advantage of this, like unless the normal HTTPS calls, it requires some time. We need a network connections to push our upstreams and download our responses, not like that. So once you push to the Google Play service, it will be having that messages in a queue. So you can see the live example here. The Wi-Fi is keeps on as all the time. It's keep on coming and going in the room. So if I going to push some messages to my to the clients client applications, so what you'll do is it will put all the messages in a queue. And of course, it has some limitations. So it will put all the messages in a queue. One day, when the client applications goes to the network available areas, you can easily able to access the network and you can able to pass the response, whatever things was getting. And so the idea what we done is here is like use the GCM server and the device admin, the API what Android's default provider. And we're going to show some demo like how remotely we can lock a device and how remotely we can wipe the data of the device. Lock in the device in the sense I'm not going to lock only the lock feature of these functionalities. I can reset the password remotely so that the other side, take for example if the employee has lost his device, so he can complain to his admin saying that he lost his device. He may have some sensitive data like mails and everything, so it will be there in the client application. So the admins come to know that device has got lost, so he can remotely lock the device setting some password what he knows. So at the time when he got back the devices, he can able to reset the password with that. And if at all, if the device was lost completely, he can wipe the data completely. So that was the main core idea. So you can see, now you can see the third party server was running, the Tomcat server. So what I've done is I'm just refreshing this thing. You can see the data was returned. And you can see the list of things the employees' applications was installed in the list view, side of this view. So whenever if two or more employees or a number of employees going to include in that, so you're going to have a refresh icon there. Once the user refreshes, it keeps track the list of the users in there. So what admin need to do is, so you can see here the request ID. So intentionally I just skipped this thing, request ID to know you guys. Usually you can put an hash map, you can map with some device one or device with the names and we can do it. But intentionally I show this request ID, what we are getting from registration from GCM server and what we are getting back to the device side. So this registration ID, what I'm doing is I'm just logging that remote device. Whenever you go for a demo, it will happen. And you can see the password, I set some password like random 1, 2, 3. So it will be so what we tried is actually what we couldn't achieve in this HackNight is like we tried something new thing. Instead of having this HTTPS thing, what old thing for provider, we tried something like CCS, cloud connection service. So what basically is like, now the thing is like what I'm doing is I'm connecting the two things. One is the GCM layer, what it was providing from the Google Play service, and the normal HTTPS protocol, what is going to make the third party server to make these things happen. So with the CCS, what we can do is we can use the same layer what is provided by the Google Pay service. You can put a minimum kind of data on upstream, so that it will keep the same way how it was provided, pushing the data to the number of devices. So you can hold all the data in a queue. Again, it's going to be in the same way. You can hold all the things in the queue, and whenever that particular server, you can be able to make the connection, will push with third party server. That way we can do it. So the main thing we can make use of this, like a tic-tac thing, what the interaction will be like. It's a kind of a WhatsApp kind of app, we can able to do it easily. If you want to integrate in this way. And one more thing is like last functionality, what I do is I'm going to wipe the data. It's gone. So data should be totally wiped. And the camera functionalities again, so it was just an hard-coded things what we are given here to be open, because the CCS functionality what we are about to plan was not work perfectly for us. So once that happened, we can easily upstream or lateral long. Whenever users moves on here and there, we can easily make use of it. Of course, we can use a location manager to send the third party servers, but it will be a battery consuming. So instead of that, we plan in that way, but it will be.
How different is this from the Google device administration?
Google administrators, like, we need to give it manually. So instead of remotely accessing some things, we need to give it something else manually, and you need to set some time or some things to be run in the same. Mainly it's kind of in the IT admin kind of things, you can have a good user interface, what the employees was doing. Of course, we haven't added the most functionalities, what we can able to do into this thing. You can able to set the password strength of this. And of course, Android is providing many, it's minimal kind of admin what we can able to do it. So it's kind of what you said is we can able to think of, it's kind of a library kind of a thing, and we can go it forward.
I have one more question, Ashish. Awesome, Manishar. I was just wondering, you know, given what you guys have built, do you think it would make sense even to restrict the apps being installed on the device?
Restrictions?
So basically, what you're doing now is just using or controlling the settings of the phone, right?
Yes.
So, but from a device admin, for example, an IT person, he would want to like restrict the apps what a particular user is going to install. Or what he can open.
Yes, he can able to do it. It's kind of a R&D kind of thing. I can able to propose a certain things, like whenever users go for an, a certain things, the launcher will be triggered, and the application what's running in the background, we can able to get it. Basically the application name, something we can able to get it. So with that, we can able to we can able to have an callback from the this thing, a client application what was running from there, and you can able to lock it. That's what we can able to do. And other than that, I don't think so. We can able to go and restrict or go and uninstall the applications remotely. It's not possible unless you root the device. So what happened is myself and my friend got rooted devices. So when we installed this admin app, so it was sitting in the background. We can't able to uninstall it normally going from the application manager. So you need to go to the thing like rooted device, and you need to uninstall that thing. So that is the main advantage.
That would basically mean you also need to write a launcher request.
Yes.